Thank you very much, and hello again. I'm very happy that I have such a great audience. If I know that Corrado is giving a talk in another room, I know Corrado for a very long time, and I'm happy that you join my session. I would like to ask in the beginning, who of you is already using Magento? Oh, so why are you here? You already know what makes Magento special, so. This is the problem, no. Okay, Bertrand from Magento. I hope I can give you some of my thoughts why I think Magento is special. Okay, I'm quite often asked this question, what makes Magento special? And I have to admit, I'm working with Magento, I think, for more than 5 or 6 years. And sometimes I ask myself also, what's the most important answer to this question, what makes Magento special? And I have gathered some information and some ideas. I hope you don't know all of them. And I can present something new. And so let's get started. So I want to start with a very bold statement. I think Magento makes you successful, and Magento can change your life. I know I sound a little bit like an American, even if I'm a German, but I think I have good reasons to make such a statement. But especially the last part, how Magento can change your life, will be at the end of my presentation. Let's start with some more facts. So basically, I try to structure my presentation in these 5 topics. First, I would like to give you some insights about the market share of Magento. Then I would like to speak about the what I call strategic open source advantage. Then I would prove how Magento can be good for beginners and for the enterprises, and especially why this matter. And I think, as you can see in this audience here, we have people from almost all around the world, and this is what you can see at all the Magento events. I think it's special that Magento is somehow internationally or even globally, and I also will explain why I think this is important. And last but not least, I will say a few words about this unparalleled community that you can find on such events, but also on the forums and the internet. And I think sometimes it's called the big Magento family, and I will come to this point at the end of my talk. Then I think I have to clarify something in the beginning. So first of all, you're very welcome to ask me questions. Thank you for the very first question. Second, I'm not an employee of Magento. Okay? So if it comes to product details, I'm not the right person to answer this question. The only thing, maybe I can give this question to the guys from Magento. The only thing that I know is there is a new public roadmap. Do you want to just jump in and... The funny thing is, yesterday when we met, he said, okay, this is probably one of the first questions.
Yeah, yeah. So so the question is, what is the roadmap? At Imagine this year, it was announced, the timeline for Magento 2. Thank you. Oh, sorry. It was announced the timeline for getting Magento 2 out. So right now, we're still working in with Magento 1. It'll be around for quite some time. So if you're going to make, when are you going to have your, would you like to start your store up?
Second half of next year.
Second half of next year. I'd say let's talk. Let's talk after after this meeting, and we'll talk about that timeline. Maybe you can make a good decision. But yeah, we're getting more information out there as far as what we want people to know what we're doing. So we'll talk after this.
Maybe I can briefly answer my thoughts on this question, because as you know, I'm not working for Magento, so I have an own business. And one of the next projects that we are going to launch is a Magento SaaS solution. It will be called Bluegento. You can find our booth out there. But before we made a decision if we want to invest our time and money in this new project, we were also doing a kind of market research. We were looking around what other platforms are around and stuff like this. And you will find some of the answers that we found in our market research in this presentation. And we, for us, have chosen Magento, even if we do not know what the future will be in 3 or 5 years. But for the moment, we think it's still the very best platform in the market, and it's a solid foundation for our business, at least. Okay. By the way, I'm not paid by Magento. I'm not giving this. This is my own opinion. Sorry? Okay, thank you very much. Okay, let's come back. So I think most of you have found the statistics from Tom Robert Charles, a good friend of mine, and he is regularly doing some surveys, and he finds out on the basis of, I think, the top million Alexa sites that Magento is the market leader in not only the, let's say, whole picture, so if you have the overall market share, I think Magento is somewhere in the 25%, but also it's market leader in several market segments. You find it in, for example, in the smaller segment, and even in the mid-size market, and even in the enterprise market, and in every segment, Magento is, if not the leading, but within the leading group of these. And I think this matters when it comes to all the other things, like how can you build a relationship with your capabilities, with developers and stuff like this. And also, Magento is known in not only a single market like Germany or Italy. For example, I come from Germany and we have a lot of competitors like Shopware or like Oxid. By the way, they are doing a really good job and it's a good proper solution. It's also most in PHP, but none of them have been successfully outside of Germany. And this is special for Magento that you can almost go around the globe and everybody has heard about Magento and they are working with Magento. So this is what I say, this is an advantage and this makes Magento very special compared to all other platforms. You also find, for example, some of the enterprise platforms like Hypress or ATG that are known around the globe, but they are very focused on their enterprise segment, but you can't find them in the lower market. Also, I think I will come to this back when I speak about why it's important for beginners and enterprise, why I think it's matter that you have this market leading or this position in different sizes of the market. Okay, I think this is the very first point. I think this is special. Magento is unparalleled in this, so you can't find any other platform that is both leading in the market globally and in different segments. Let's come to what I call the strategic open source advantage. I think you know from the beginning that Magento started as an open source solution. Compared to others, they later decided to become open source, but it was not a real strategic decision. And this was different with Magento. I think when you are using Magento already, I do not have to explain much about the advantages of open source. But maybe I should share a story with you. I had a long discussion with Roy and Joachim, the two founders, and they told me in the beginning they were keen on changing the market, bring up a product that is really compelling, but they were not really, let's say, clear about how they can make money of it. And I think this is typical for open source. And when they announced the Enterprise Edition, it was interesting to see how the market reacted. For example, the Germans are very open to open source, but very critical when it comes to any commercialization of open source. So there were a lot of blog posts saying, oh, the Enterprise Edition, this is the end of Magento. So this was the skeptical German view on open source. In America, vice versa, it was then considered a real product. This means, so nothing changed basically in the product itself, but the perception of the market was totally different. Now people said, if there's a price tag on it, the guys are taking it serious, so we can rely on this. Also, there was Meet Magento a few weeks ago in Germany, and one guy from the community made a very critical talk about enterprise and it makes it, does it make sense or does it not make sense? And the interesting thing is, afterwards there was a discussion, and you also can see two sides of the medal, and I try to describe it in this way. You have normally two kind of people or businesses out there. One have endless time and no money. For them, a community project is perfect because they can invest their time, get a very good product, because they have time. This also fits to very to maybe startups especially. They are normally not so so proper founded, but they have plenty of time, so they can invest in this. Vice versa, if an enterprise business, they are normally have money to invest because they have already earned some money, but they are short in time. They have a totally different approach to this. And so you can see, by having a community project or product and an enterprise product, you can have a strategic decision on Magento because it will fit in all cases. I think I do not want to argue about what's better or not because I think it depends on your situation. If you have the money and you can afford it and it fits to your business case, there are very good reasons for the enterprise solution. And if you say, I'm not so sure about how can I start, then I think it's good to start with Magento. And I think this is also a good, let's say, move over to these beginners and enterprise topic I would like to talk about. When I was dealing with our clients, a lot of projects were difficult when they started with a different platform. So the typical situation is somebody comes in, wants to sell something online. It doesn't matter if it's a mom and pop store or it's a producer or even a bigger merchant. In the beginning, you are not so experienced and you have no clue if you will be successful in the internet or not. So you have a kind of uncertainty. And in this situation, if you start, for example, with whatever platform, and let's say you are doing a lot of things right and your business is growing and growing, you hit a certain point where you have to make a serious decision about your platform. Maybe you need an ERP connection or you need additional capabilities or whatever. Lucky you if you have chosen a platform that you can grow with, because then you don't have to migrate all your data and you don't have to reintegrate all the services that you have already integrated. You might say, it's not a big deal. So we make a project, 3 months, and then we switch from one platform to another platform. From my experience, and I don't want to scare you, this is a nightmare. Because you have to imagine, you're already running an online store, you have to take care about your customers, and then switching to another platform, redoing all the integration, migrating all the data, you get, let's say, the history of your clients, the history of orders. I saw a lot of projects where this was very business critical for these, for those merchants, because this is a special situation and it can, let's say, flatten your growth line at this point. And I think in this very competitive situation, e-commerce and internet, I would choose a platform that it's ready for growth. That means you can start small, but you know that over the long run, if you are successful, and this is the aim of all businesses, then you do not have to choose the platform. And this is very important from my point of view. And once again, I think this is very special with Magento, that you have this growth path, that you can start with a community solution. That means you don't even have to spend a lot of money. But if you think, oh, now I need enterprise functionality, I need integration, whatever, you can stay with community, but you are also open to go the enterprise path. And this is very special for Magento again. Sorry, I have to look up that I do not forget any important things. Okay. Let's come to this point where I think it is very important that you have a global or an international platform. You might argue that if you are just working in a specific country, like say Italy, that it's not important for you if the platform is well known outside of your country. But how does the situation for a merchant normally look like? To be honest, I have no insights on the Italian market, how mature the e-commerce sector is already. But from my home market, Germany, I can say that you only have a few, let's say, strategies how you can succeed in the internet. So it does not make sense to have a whole assortment because then you are competing with Amazon, and I think this is a totally different topic. So normally you choose a market niche where you are selling in a specific niche online. This is a chance that you have. But let's say over 1 or 2 or 3 years, you somehow have conquered your market niche, and then you have two options. Maybe you spread out to another market niche that it's close by, or, and this is in my opinion the often better option, to go abroad. Because a lot of merchants just sell in their local market, but I think if you have a very good domain experience with your assortment, with your clients and so on, then it's much easier to do cross-border business or to expand in an international way. And especially this is something very, let's say, unique for Europe, that we have the European Union, you have free trade, you have very good logistic. So this is an opportunity that you, at least in my opinion, could not miss, at least considering going and doing business abroad. And then I think it's very handy if you go to, let's say, your neighbor country and figure out, hey, the payment system that I need has already an integration for Magento. It might be an extension, it might be a plugin, whatever. Or, and then just give me a little side note to thank the sponsor eBay and PayPal of this. Especially for the cross-border business, you find a lot of capabilities within the eBay family already that helps you to sell cross-border. You can use PayPal. This is an easy way for collecting money from the outside. Or you can test the market and if you use the certain eBay marketplaces to see if your product fits to a different market. So once again, I think this is special because, as I said in the beginning, there are some platforms that are very strong in a specific market. But what happens if you hit this border and say, okay, now I want to go abroad? Yeah, they might have some language packets. They might have an integration. But it's much easier if you go to a country where you even find a partner who maybe already is dealing with this. And you can say, hey, are you also using Magento? It's easier for us to work together. So this is where I think this is special for Magento, and it also matters for you as a merchant. Okay. Any questions so far? Okay. The last point is this unparalleled community and this ecosystem. And before I speak about this ecosystem and community, please allow me to say some words about what I'm currently doing. And I think this also will answer the question at the beginning, why we have chosen Magento and why we think it's worth spending time and money on this. So we asked ourselves quite a time ago, what is this, what brings us, or what makes us happy at work, why are we going to work? It's not just making money. And we asked ourselves, so what is the deeper purpose why we are going to work? And we figured out after quite a long time that basically it's we would like to connect people, to enable them to see how the market can evolve. And we thought that Magento is a perfect fit to this, because Magento is a very good platform that can exactly what you see here, connect people, and also is enabling people. Because a lot of merchants never thought about e-commerce before. Magento gives them a platform to start doing a new business. So what is, or what do we try to contribute to this, let's say, ecosystem or to this business environment? So first of all, we have this Meet Magento events. I would like to speak about a little bit later. But then we figured out that you can find a lot of extension. I think you know extensions, you know Magento Connect. But there are some, I would slightly call it quality improvements necessary. or put it short, you find a lot of crap out there. And thank you. We were trying to improve this quality, and we developed a little tool. It's called Judge. You can Google it later on. Basically, you can upload any extension you find on the internet, and it gives you a kind of scoring. It's not a perfect one, but it's more kind of indicator, and this scoring can help you to make an educated decision. Is this extension going to work as it is described? Or at least it's not technically harming my store. By the way, it's an open source project. And if somebody from the developer community would like to engage and work with us, we are happy for any contribution. Another thing that we try to bring to the community and to grow this market is we started together with a lot of community developers to have so-called localized editions. What is a localized edition? So basically, if you download Magento, it's the international version, and you have to do some tweaks. You have to install a language pack. You have to configure your text settings, and a lot of, let's say, customization that makes Magento usable in your certain market. And we have the so-called localized editions. This is a full download package, not just an extension. It's a Magento community edition plus all the configuration, and you can start it out of this installation package, and then you have it suitable for your local market. At the moment, we have it for Switzerland, for Germany, and for Austria. And we are working on Spain, Italy, France, and I think two or three other countries. And I'm very happy that I can announce that the Italian version will be available by end of this month, latest by beginning of July. So I think watch out, and I would also like to have your feedback if you have tried your localized editions. And last but not least, and this is a little commercial break at this point, I said in the beginning that we at the moment try to even make it easier, not only have a download package, but also a pre-installed kind of SaaS solution. We call it Blugento. And in this situation, we have once again reduced a bit of complexity. And it is especially tailored for the very beginners in the market. So if, let's say, a little store wants to go online, having already an offline store, sometimes it's not easy to get the first steps with e-commerce, and so we try to lower down the entry barrier. But you are also allowed to grow out of this SaaS solution, and this is very special that you can take your SaaS solution later on when you grow and go for a free whatever community or enterprise edition. Thank you for this little commercial break. You remember my first slide when I said, okay, Magento can change your life. So I just have a few minutes left, so I just want to come back to this. I think what I explained, these Meet Magento events are independently organized. We rely on partners like Diego here in Italy, and we are very proud that we have such a great network of passionate people that bring together such events. And this is something that you also find very seldom in the whole IT solution. I think Meet Magento, from our perspective, is not only the events. It should be a platform for sharing knowledge, for sharing ideas, and where we connect people. For example, I can give you a lot of examples where people came to a Meet Magento event, they found their new developer, or they have chosen their new agency, or they found a capability like a logistic or payment company. And if they're not working together, at least they were in contact and they were changing how to improve a service, how can we add some value to this. And this is what we try to aim. And we would like all contributions. So for example, we are working with Firegento. Sylvain is a representative from the Firegento Association. This is a kind of group who is organizing hackathons. This is where the developers meet and hack and fix bugs. And we would like to have this as a platform where the people come together, not only for business, not only for development, but because we think it makes sense when all of these groups work together and join. And now, last but not least, because I know the time is running, we also are able to create some friendships, not only the friendship of developers or the organizers. There was one example from a good friend of mine, Philippe Humeau from France. By the way, he met his wife at one of the Meet Magento Germany events. And I think 1 year later, they got married. So I think this is an extreme example for how Magento can change your life. And I do not want to say, go out and find your new spouse. But I would say, please go out, connect with the Meet Magento crowd, become successful, make friends, change your life. Thank you very much. And of course, if there are any questions, whether you ask me now or I'm here all the days, thank you very much.